So please try to make yourself as comfortable as possible while still keeping the back straight. It's good to think in terms of lifting the chin a little bit. Whenever we think of meditation, we always think of the, some of us anyway, think of this statue of the Buddha where he's got this perfect straight back and his chin is lifted. And for most of us, just allow the eyes to close. So it doesn't matter if you're sitting on a cushion or a chair, if you're leaning against the wall or the back of the chair. Just try not to round the back too much and try to stack the vertebrae one on top of each other, just like stacking coins. And then that'll help you stay alert, and it'll help the breathing and the energy flow up and down the body. And it also helps to tighten the abdomen a little bit, and it helps with the alertness. So we can start by just asking ourselves how we feel. And do we have a state of mind that we could refer to? And do we feel content or happy, or stressed out perhaps, or confused? Do we feel concentrated? All these different states, once we notice them, we can just see them as a movement rather than any kind of stationary idea or any kind of a stagnant mindset. And particularly once we notice it and identify it, it changes immediately. So once we ask ourselves how we feel, what kind of mind state are we having, as long as we're really looking for that, investigating, we're actually meditating. The problem is that the mind will wander away from that. It might ask, how did I feel a little while ago? Or why do I feel this way? What happened earlier to make me feel this way? Or I wonder if I can feel better in the future. So all these things come up in the form of thoughts. But when we're actively investigating in the present moment, we're mindful and we're meditating. The wandering mind is, in some respects, the opposite of meditation. But it's also a learning tool. When we notice the mind wandering away, we just simply notice it, catch it, and bring it back, just like training a puppy on a leash. So we bring our attention back, and we need an object to bring our attention back to. A meditation object of sorts. And for most of us, we just simply use the sensation of the breath as we breathe in and breathe out. Some of us feel the movement of the air as it comes in and as it leaves the body. Some notice the movement of the body itself, the movement of the diaphragm, and how the lungs move the air in and out of the body. Most of us just notice the sensation of the air as it passes into the nostrils and out of the nostrils, just the area at the tip of the nose almost. So just take a few moments and focus on the breath. Notice where you feel the breathing. Notice where you feel the breath the most, where it comes in and then leaves the body. Once you find that spot, just tell yourself that this is your meditation object. It's like a place in the body where you feel the breath or notice the breath. The sensation of breathing. Now notice if you can place some light concentration on that and just stay there without allowing your attention to be pulled away in any form or any way. Just staying with the breath. So we're using the breath as the meditation object. We're not trying to change the breath or manipulate it. We're just noticing it. Just trying to breathe as normal as possible. And then when the thoughts come into the mind, in other words, when the mind starts wandering, we can just notice that and kind of pay attention to it a little bit and then come back to the breath. So if a mind state comes up that should be noticed, we take a look at it, then we come back to the breath. So the breath is the foundation. It's like our flagpole in a windstorm. It's something to hang on to. And we can, from this vantage point, we can do a lot of investigating without allowing the mind to wander off too far. Eventually we can realize that we can be very, very close, concentrated on the breath, and there's nothing else happening. At other times we might notice a sensation or a feeling of the body, maybe a visualization, a sound or a smell or something. And we're still very, very close to being connected with the breath, even though these things are happening. And that way we can investigate what's happening while still staying connected with the breathing, with the breath itself. This is really the whole idea behind meditation, is placing light focus, concentration on the object, which is the breath, and then when the mind interacts with the world, which it will, we just notice it and then bring our attention back to the breath. Begin to notice the thoughts. The thoughts become very still. They come one after another. They can seem to be very organized and non-evasive. Things happen without any reaction. But they're still seen or experienced. Or heard. Thank you. So bring your attention to the breath. It's a good opportunity to ask yourself again, what mind state are you experiencing at this moment? Notice how different than it is from the mind state that you originally identified at the beginning of the meditation. See how everything is completely endlessly changing, just flowing along.